In the mid-afternoon hours of August 20th of 2023, the rain and wind from Tropical Storm Hilary began bearing down on California, representing the state's first tropical storm since 1939. Because of the expected heavy rainfall and severe flooding, people might have been surprised to suddenly receive a shake alert warning that an earthquake was going to strike in the next 15 seconds. And yet, at 2:41 p.m. local time, a moderate magnitude 5.1 earthquake struck at shallow depths on the northwestern edge of the Los Angeles metropolitan area. During the following 15 seconds, a broad area ranging from Los Angeles to Tulare to Ridgecrest shook, with the strongest shaking occurring at the earthquake's epicenter. This caused some items to fall off of shelves at nearby shops, but otherwise did not appear to cause any major damage. Strangely, this quake occurred at an unnamed fault line that appears to have not moved at any point in the last 1 million years. The apparent coincidence of the hurricane and unusual magnitude earthquake striking California on the same day caused many people to ask, did the hurricane cause this earthquake? Some people in various news articles even speculated that one caused the other. And yet, this proclamation is not based in reality. With this specific topic, there is a large disconnect between what many people believe and what is actually scientifically true, much like how some people think that when the moon is closest to Earth in its slightly variable orbit, that it triggers a greatly increased rate of earthquakes. After all, much like hurricanes change the amount of atmospheric pressure in a region, it could sound initially logical that this pressure change could cause an earthquake. Yet, the variable orbit of our moon does not cause an increased rate of earthquakes when it is closest, and Tropical Storm Hilary did not cause the earthquake to occur. I will admit that the last time the vicinity surrounding the magnitude 5.1 earthquake last had a similarly energetic event was also in the 1930s, in the same decade that the last tropical storm struck the region. Yet, the magnitude 5.0 struck in 1930, while the tropical storm hit in 1939. Yesterday's magnitude 5.1 earthquake struck just north of a notable ridge that has numerous west-to-east trending fault lines. Based on its magnitude, it appears that 1.24 miles of the fault line ruptured in this event. And this just so happens to be slightly shorter than the 1.7-mile length this small fault line has. As for the type of fault line, it involved what is known as an oblique fault line. More specifically, what moved was an oblique right lateral reverse fault. In other words, this quake had both a vertical and horizontal motion component to it. In the vertical component, the hanging wall of the fault line moved upwards in comparison to the foot wall. Yet, at the same time, from a top-down view, the right side block moved towards the viewer, representing its horizontal component. If you combine these two vectors, you get the exact motion of the earthquake which occurred. As for the lack of connection between earthquakes and heavy rainfall, this topic has been studied for decades specifically within California, and only found that rain can potentially affect the rate of earthquakes during a narrow set of circumstances, none of which occurred due to the hurricane. For example, it has been found that during increased periods of snowmelt combined with increased rainfall across a several-month period, that the rate of earthquakes can increase, but only in regions which have active volcanoes. This can occur as an increased amount of water seeps into a volcano's hydrothermal system, which can then lubricate a fault line and make it easier for a slip to occur. Yet, there are no active volcanoes where August 20th's earthquake occurred. However, it has been found that sustained heavy periods of rainfall in non-volcanic areas can cause a slight increase in the rate of earthquakes within California, but only for micro-earthquakes, aka quakes which have a magnitude of 2.0 or less. Thus, what occurred yesterday with two fairly uncommon natural phenomena striking on the same day was merely an unlikely coincidence. As a final note, here are the USGS stay-at-odds that various magnitude earthquakes could strike in the vicinity of the aforementioned 5.1 quake by 8:50 a.m. local time on August 28, 2023. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.